Welcome, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us for yet another installment of Talks at GS. Now, Ken, someone who really doesn't need much introduction, he is the founder of a venture platform called Invamed. He is perhaps best known as co-founder of Home Depot. Neal is the CEO and founder of Relationship Science. He was the co-founder in 2004 of CapIQ. Thank you for being here with us today. Now, Ken, there's nothing more sacrosanct than relationships. Are relationships an art or a science from your perspective?
They're both. They're absolutely both. It's where you can marry the science and the art. And admittedly, I think the art form is ultimately what clinches the deal. At the end of the day, the decision is made, all these things you said to the potential client, does the client believe you can do it? That's it. To get to the client is where the science is. And what excited me about when Neal came in to see me, what, 5-6 years ago? And he showed me this thing, I couldn't believe it. And I'm thinking of how many hours, how many days I spent calling people up, did you know so-and-so? And if you knew so-and-so, could you call so-and-so for me and say this and so forth? I mean, this thing was compressed in seconds.
So, Neal, I'm going to start by just asking you in a very short way to summarize what is RELSI?
Sure. So we map the most, let's call it, active, influential people across business, finance, nonprofit, politics, law, society. So 4 million people that are generally the people that a firm like this would be doing business with, and the 1.5 million organizations with which they're affiliated. What we do from that is we lift off a estimated social graph. So who likely knows who and how? So this is not based on any social network data. Nobody has to give us anything, any information, or friend anybody. We just figure it out by aggregating and reverse engineering these relationships. Then a firm syncs up their relationships. Who do we know? Who our partners know? And that's in a proprietary fashion. Now it's live. There's this live social graph of how does this firm link to the entire world. And if you didn't have a system like this, you'd probably figure out how do we get to that person? We need to show this deal to that company. How do we solve this problem by getting in contact with that particular individual? This system will give you that answer in a second, and I'll give you all the possibilities of all the relationships. So in a nutshell, it's taking the value of relationships that exist in an institution that's very opaque, and who knows what that means, and trying to bring it to light. That's what we do.
That's great. And one of the things that was really fascinating to me about this, the uses of this technology seem so obvious to a place like Goldman Sachs, but actually one of the interesting things is all the other places that it's used in our broad economy. Maybe offer a few other little tidbits.
Sure. So we work with law firms, some of the biggest law firms, private equity funds, hedge funds, lots of universities. So anything from broadly defined business development. So if you're a nonprofit and you're raising money, who do my donors know? How do I maximize my board? Who of the potential donor base, which are most close in proximity to my board as a whole, where are the most relationships? You take a hedge fund. There's also a knowledge component, because what we know about is sort of things we've done, deals we've worked on, companies we've invested in, where we've worked. There's also just strategic step back of who should we be targeting,
right,
and why. Such like just a couple, a private equity fund. Who might likely invest in a renewable energy fund that we know?
Just basically shortcutting what used to be very laborious, imperfect, hand-to-hand combat kind of processes.
Yeah, like at Capital IQ, which some of you are familiar with, it was about, you'd be up all night trying to get the information on your desk and all the numbers out, and then after 8 hours, you'd, look at a piece of paper and draw some insights. It's the same thing. It's why spend all day trying to map this all out? We can do it for you.
So Ken, it sounds like one of the reasons this rang so much out to you is that you, before the days of this technology and as you built your career, you did a lot of work.
I was a peddler, and I wanted to sell something to somebody, and I had to get to somebody to sell it to them. It was that simple. You take your wealth management, your wealth asset management people here. My God, this is, I'm pitching his business. And I should, because I looked at it and I said, my God, wow. As a salesman, as somebody who wants to get in front of somebody. And more importantly, it's going to give me some flavor of the person, what they like, what their interests are. And you only have so much time. That's the other thing. Don't forget, when you're in front of somebody, you haven't got all the time in the world. Yeah. I'm back to the wealth management guys. They understand this. Okay, that's why.
Where do you see it going, Neal? I mean, it's such a powerful tool today, but and not just Ralph's side generally, but the art and science of relationships. How much, where's the room for more innovation, more power here?
I'll tell you something, what's next that we do that's really exciting is actionable alerts. So it's kind of taking an event, intuiting an opportunity, and drawing a path. So a company in Chicago raises $10 million. So no news story, files a Form D. Well, if you are a wealth manager, it might be a very interesting time to call the CEO, right? Because it's and by the way, to see immediately, oh, my client X can introduce me to him. You'll be, it's opportunity and how to do it, all in one.
We often think about relationship building with companies. This takes it down to a deeply personal level. So you get alerts every morning about any news about that specific person, and it reminds you that the essence of relationships are not institutions, but people.
Absolutely.
Ken, what would be, if you had a list of the two or three or four key attributes of great relationship building? Obviously, be informed is one that you've talked about, but what are the others that are the essence of your relationship building philosophy?
They all are outgrowths of the word truth.
Hmm.
A little humility.
Right.
Really putting yourself in the position of the person you're trying to sell to, if you're trying to sell them something, and ask yourself the question, is this something I should have or need to have? And I say this all the time to the kids in the store. I tell the kids in the store, don't sell the customer anything they don't want or they don't need. Don't do that. You make sure that customer knows one thing, that you're going to give him the best deal. I don't know if I'd like to tell a little story about truth.
Please, yeah.
And I know the man this happened to. I had a kid that worked out here in the Jericho store in Long Island. And a guy on a Saturday morning, apparently his faucet was dripping, drip, 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 drip. And his wife kept him up all night. She couldn't sleep with the drip, and he couldn't sleep with her foot. So he gets up in the morning, and he takes the stem out of the faucet, and he goes to the store, and he says to the kid, he said, give me one of these things here. He said, I need it. And the kid looks at it, and he said, sir, you don't need a whole new stem. He said, let me help you. So he goes over to the plumbing department, and he takes a pack, 25-cent pack of rubber washers, all different sizes, and he opens it up. He takes a screwdriver he had in his apron, and he unscrews the brass screw. He takes the old washer out that was brittle because it was old. He puts a new one in, and he puts the screw back, and he says to the man here, just go put it back. You won't have a drip. 2 months later, now the man that got the service tells me this story. 2 months later, the wife wakes up on one Saturday morning and said, we need a new kitchen. She wants to take him to some foo-foo place, And he says, nope, I'm going to see my buddy at Home Depot. We sold them a $105,000 kitchen because that kid gave him a 2-cent washer, but more importantly, demonstrated that we didn't need the sale, that he didn't need to buy something from us. I can't stress enough the importance of the truth and sincerity and honesty. If you don't know the answer, you don't know the answer. Don't wing it, okay? It's worked okay for me.
I'll tell you something that we've done, that we did at Capital IQ. When a banker got laid off, the first thing I would do is say, I want to give you a free subscription or, complimentary subscription for 6 months.
Wow.
And, when that person ended up somewhere, right, and that was,
interesting.
Yeah, and that was post 9/11, and all those people ended up at places.
Right.
And all those people remembered that. And, again, it wasn't done at the time out of any specific commercial focus, but, also just people say, I'm investing in this company, and I'd say, oh, you should meet so-and-so. And just people, it's a great way to just build friendship, build relationship, and then if you ever do yourself have a need, they're very willing to assist.
It's a fascinating insight about your platform. Actually, one of the things that we worried about, which is, again, the sanctity of relationships, are people going to view the relationships being precious? Will they guard them? Will they be reluctant to put them into this, to identify people as relationships? And we found quite the opposite. And I think it's very much born out of what you say, was that by activating those relationships and providing a venue to make those people more connected, and it's a gift.
Absolutely.
Ken, you're obviously very passionate about the company. You've used the software a lot. As we roll it out more broadly, how would you exhort us to use it? What's the one thing that we could do that would make a difference with this kind of a platform?
I don't think I have to say this here, but don't abuse it. If you get in front of somebody through the use of it, make sure you make good use of that time, because we can't help you. We cannot help you there. Okay, this is not give you the chance to be error-free. Once you get where you want to be with that client or that potential client, then it's all on your nickel. And just make sure you take advantage of that opportunity to sell them something or to do something with them or whatever. So that's all I can say, because relationships are wonderful, but they're very fragile too.
Ken Langone and Neal Goldman, thank you so much for being with us. Terrific.